China lashing out at the Philippines as it again accuses Manila of reneging on its promises in the South China Sea. Beijing's foreign ministry claims Manila continues to make provocations in the South China Sea by relying on support from what it called external forces. It also slammed the Philippines for allegedly violating a memorandum of understanding on properly managing maritime tensions and the declaration on the conduct of parties in the South China Sea.
The Philippines, backed by external forces, has been going back on its words and making provocations. This is the real cause of the current tensions at sea. Nothing will hide the truth. And no one should turn black into white. The Philippines needs to immediately stop violating China's sovereignty and its provocations and return to observing the spirit of the DOC. China will not waver in its resolve to safeguard its territorial sovereignty and maritime rights and interests.
China's IR follows the creation of a National Maritime Council under the Marcos administration. Despite Beijing's remarks, the National Security Council says the Philippines will exhaust all diplomatic measures to resolve tensions in the West Philippine Sea.
Marami sa ating mga kababayan, akala nila yung counter-response natin or measures natin ay purely military. Hindi po, no? The measures cover multi-dimensions, and this is one aspect of that. Madalas nakafocus lang tayo sa West Philippine Sea, ngunit meron pa tayo mga ibang challenges. For example, yung sa Benham Rise, nasa east side ng ating bansa, yung nasa north side natin sa Batanes, no? Sa south, yung facing Indonesia and Malaysia. So lahat po ng lugar na yan requires maritime domain awareness.
The National Maritime Council will be composed of several government agencies. It will be responsible for formulating policies and strategies that will safeguard Philippine waters. The president's sister, Senator Aimee Marcos, opposes the creation of the National Maritime Council. For her, the measure attracts what she called Trojan horses of foreign interference through donations, grants, and gifts, which the council has been authorized to accept. Senator Marcos also says emotion rather than reason has prevailed in Manila's maritime conflict with Beijing, and it could lead to what she called a dangerous path. She adds any action that may put Filipinos in danger is gross irresponsibility. Turning now to the so-called gentleman's agreement between China and the Duterte administration. A former spokesperson of former President Rodrigo Duterte says such a deal never existed. Attorney Salvador Panelo says he talked to Duterte about it and he said he never entered into any gentleman's agreement with China regarding Ayungin Shoal. Panelo adds whoever made the claim only wants publicity. It was attorney Harry Roque who revealed the previous administration had an agreement with China to maintain the status quo in Ayungin Shoal. For a former Supreme Court Associate Justice, the deal is a disguised surrender of the exclusive economic zone rights of the Philippines over Ayungin Shoal.
Yung gentleman's agreement na hindi tayo magdala ng mga construction materials to repair BRT Sierra Madre. Mali yun. Kasi everybody knows na magko-collapse na yung BRT Sierra Madre kasi ang tagal na yan, rusty na yung superstructure niyan, kaya kailangan i-repair natin. Yung pumayag si Duterte na hindi tayo mag-repair, eh, that's against our interest. Yun ang gusto ng China, mag-collapse, tapos wala na tayo. Eh, it's against our interest. Talagang dehado tayo sa gentleman's agreement na yan.
A Texas-based cybersecurity firm warns of threats to the Philippines from China-backed hackers. CrowdStrike says these hackers use generative artificial intelligence for surveillance and intellectual property theft in Southeast Asia. The Philippine ICT department also sees a threat from local hackers. It believes the misinformation and disinformation carried by social media sites are linked to next year's midterm polls.
A lot of disinformation is going to increase in the social media sites, especially in Facebook and in TikTok, going to the 2025 elections. You see this already being practiced or experimented on journalists. There are a lot of robocalls or fake videos being generated, mimicking journalists and even our past presidents and our incumbent presidents. And we advise the public to be more vigilant with disinformation and misinformation. Please do not use Facebook. Please do not use TikTok as your source of news. The motivation is usually to affect the outcome of the election in order to put leaders who are more sympathetic to their cause.
Vice President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. taps Police Major General Romel Francisco Marbil as the new chief of the Philippine National Police. He replaced retired Police General Benjamin Acorda Jr. Prior to his appointment, Marbil served as PNP's Director of Controllership. He also led the Highway Patrol Group before serving as the Regional Director of Police Regional Office 8. The new police chief, eyeing to utilize technology to combat local and transnational crimes in the country.
We shall prioritize integrating the PNP secured mobile artificial intelligence driven and real-time smart policing program and ICT development roadmap in our operations, including an active drive to recruit and train a new generation of police officers and support staff with technical expertise and specialized IT skills.
Ang pangarap ko ay pangarap nyo rin. Patatag na ekonomiya, maayos na lipunan, at maayos na kapulisan. Yan po ang unang kataga na sinabi ng ating Presidente during the inauguration. Ang masasabi ko po sa inyong Excellency, Sir, matutupad po.
Marbil, who is now 55, will retire in February next year, months before the midterm elections. The World Bank keeps its 2024 economic growth forecast for the Philippines at 5.8%. It also revised its 2025 growth forecast to 5.9%, up from an earlier projection of 5.8%. This means the World Bank expects the Philippines to become the second highest growing economy in East Asia and the Pacific. The global institution says consumption and recovery in services will sustain the country's growth. It adds government reforms like the Public Services Act may generate greater foreign investments in the long run. Meanwhile, growth on a regional scale is seen to ease a 4.5% from 5.1% last year. The World Bank urges countries in the region to encourage private sector investments, resolve financial sector challenges, and boost productivity. The Philippine Central Bank sees inflation accelerating for a second straight month. It says inflation could match last month's 3.4% print or potentially rise to 4.2%. If the upper end of the central bank's estimates holds, inflation would be higher than government's target of 2 to 4%. The BSP attributes the higher forecast to the continued price increases of rice and meat and higher domestic oil prices. The Philippine Education Department allies concerns class suspensions due to extreme heat will cause learning disruptions. Since Monday, face-to-face classes in several areas have been suspended due to the scorching weather, with temperatures reaching dangerous levels in some provinces. But the DepEd says funds will be given to schools, which they can use to purchase equipment or appliances to help fight heat inside classrooms.
Wala na po tayong suspension ng classes. Wala pong learning disruption. Ang ginagawa lang po natin, ang sinususpindi natin ay suspension of in-person classes na pwedeng ideklara ng ating mga school heads, no? Depending on the situation in their school. Meron naman tayong binababang mga MOE sa ating mga schools para siguraduhin na kung nasira man yung electric fan ay mapagawa nila. And then definitely po, yung ventilation sa ating schools is something very important.
Here's a look at some of the cities and municipalities that have suspended classes for today, April 2nd.